What's going on, everybody? This is your host Manik, and I welcome you all to yet another video. Well, it's getting really hard to keep a track of updates, and this is the second update for OnePlus 8T in 1 week. And this one comes with a lot of fixes, especially for some of those issues that were annoying you since quite some time. So let's have a look at the latest OxygenOS 11.0.3.4 update for OnePlus 8T. So if you are really bothered by these tiny issues, then you can update instantly. Just download Oxygen Updater application from the Google Play Store. Now open the application and click on this download update button. Now just let it download the zip file, and once it's done, simply go to settings. Now go to system, choose system update from the list and click on this gear icon on the top right corner. Now choose local upgrade from the list and choose the zip file we just downloaded. So this will start installing the update. Now wait for a couple of minutes max, and once it's done, you will get this reboot button, so tap on that and you are done. Yes, it's that simple. But wait, the video doesn't end here. Let's have a look at the changelog now, and no new features have been added with this one as well, because the existing ones had some issues already. So starting off with the system level fixes, and the first one would be the fix for this could not install system app error that some of you were getting after the last update. And this one was too annoying. Thankfully, I did not encounter this, else my phone would have been listed on OLX. Next one in this list is the fix for status bar. And I did observe that the status bar did not hide automatically in landscape mode and used to stay on top forever. So that has also been taken care of with this update. Apart from this, we now get a toast message when you use the alert slider. So based on the position of alert slider, you get this short toast message that tells the status of device. And this might be handy for some. Apart from this, the missed touch prevention feature has been optimized to better reject accidental touches and in turn provide you with a better experience. And this update optimizes compatibility with some games to reduce lag. So what this necessarily means is you will get lesser disconnection issues with popular games like Among Us and Free Fire, probably. Also in sound and vibration, you get OnePlus Buds support now in earphone adjustment options. So the equalizer will adapt accordingly now, which is just great. Anyways, I'll of course test this update for the next couple of days and then get back to you with a conclusion. So subscribe if you haven't already. And before we move on to the camera part, let's check out the benchmark scores first. So with the previous update, the Geekbench score did increase quite a bit to 891 for the single core and 3218 in the multi-core department. And after this update, the scoreboard looks something like this. So no major changes as such, but in case you are into numbers, this might help. Now in the camera part, well, the first one states improved stability and the second one states optimize the imaging effect to bring you with a better experience. And you know what, I'll let the images speak for themselves. So here are some image samples from before and after the update. Well, they do look similar more or less, and I'm not completely satisfied with the way this front camera handles artificial lighting scenarios. Now coming to the last part in this list, and that is in the network department. So there are a couple of changes here, and the first one in simple terms states that you will get lesser connection dropouts and the experience will be better overall. And if you ask me, I did face some issues with the calls after the last update, and they used to go on silent all of a sudden. So I hope that has been taken care of with this update. The second one in this list fixes network issues with games, just like we have with OnePlus Nord. So are you facing any issues with network connection while gaming? Do let me know in the comment section down below. The battery life I started getting after the last update on 120Hz was quite good. So around 6 to 7 hours easily, and I ended up the day with some battery left. And this update also improves on that, along with some excessive heat up issue that you might have been facing for now. And that's it for now. These are all the changes you get with this latest update. And I'll be posting a full review after testing this one for a couple of days. So stay tuned and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And like this video if it helps you out. So I'll see you in the next one.